Hey guys, welcome back to this session. And in this session, we'll talk about COBOL Web Services interface. So let's get started. So first of all, let's talk about what are web services. So web services are a collection of open source protocols and standards used to exchange data between two different systems or applications. That means with the help of web services, two applications can communicate with each other over the internet. A web service has an interface which hides the implementation details. Apart from that, they use standard protocols to exchange data and functionality. Now, there are two types of web services. First one is SOAP, that is Simple Object Access Protocol, and the second one is REST, that is Representational State Transfer. And as you know that COBOL is one of the oldest programming language that is still in use, but interestingly, it can provide and request web services using the architecture based on SOAP, that is Simple Object Access Protocol, or REST, that is Representational State Transfer. Apart from that, the format commonly used for displaying data in the interface of these services are either JSON, that is JavaScript Object Notation, or XML, that is Extensible Markup Language. Now let's try to understand with the help of an example. So we have a web application which is hosted on non-mainframe platform, and we have a COBOL application which is hosted on mainframe. Now if you look at the example, you will clearly understand that a user has initiated a request from the web application to get data from the mainframe. Mainframe received the request, and the application which is hosted on IBM mainframe has processed that request, generate the output in the desired format, and again send the response back to the web application. And the data which is shared with the web application would be either in JSON format or in XML format. So far you're able to understand what are web services and how two different applications which is hosted on different platforms are used to interact with each other with the help of web services. And what is the importance of JSON and XML formats, which is used for communication or sharing data between two different applications? Now let's try to understand what are the different statements which is provided by COBOL, and these statements can be used to generate either a JSON file or XML file. Apart from that, you can also consume JSON or XML messages or document in your COBOL program. Now if you look at the diagram, you can clearly understand that on one side you have web application which is hosted on non-mainframe platform, and on the other side you have COBOL application which is hosted on IBM mainframe. Now first of all, let's say our web application is communicating with COBOL application in a JSON format. So in this case, you can use two separate COBOL statements. The first one is JSON parse statement, and this statement is used to consume the JSON message that you've received from the web application. Apart from that, you can use JSON generate statement that will convert the COBOL data item or the COBOL output into a JSON format that can be processed by a web application. And similarly, in case if your web application is using XML instead of JSON, then you can use XML parse statement to process the XML text or the XML document that you have received from the web application. And you can also use XML generate statement to generate the data items or the output of the COBOL program into an XML format that can be used by a web application. So far, if you have any question, then do let me know. Otherwise, let's move on to our next lecture. Last but not the least, if you like this video, then hit the like button and share your feedback in the comments section. And do share it with your friends. And please consider subscribing to our channel, because your subscription is very important for us. Thank you so much for watching the video.